गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ग्राफ ऑफ सीकेंट एक्स एंड कोसेकेंट एक्स एंड कॉट एक्स, राइट, रिमेनिंग थ्री ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शन. नाउ ग्राफ ऑफ सीकेंट एक्स, सी हियर, व्हाट इज सीकेंट एक्स? वी नो दैट सीकेंट एक्स इज 1/cos x, रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ कॉस. हियर इफ डिनोमिनेटर, इफ कॉस वैल्यू इज जीरो, देन 1/0 सीकेंट इज नॉट डिफाइंड. So cos value, when it will be zero? For odd multiples. If you take odd multiples of pi by 2 in place of x, then cos will be cos 90. Cos 90 value zero. 1/0 not defined. So at odd multiples of x values are odd multiples of pi by 2, then secant is not defined. Why? Because at that point cos will be zero. 1/0 not defined. So secant is not defined. So secant is not defined at odd multiples of pi by 2. So what is the domain now? Domain of secant x. Domain of secant x is, you can take all real numbers except these odd multiples of pi by 2. This is the domain of secant x, right? You should not take odd multiples. You can take any real number except these parts. So this is the domain. To know the range of the secant x, we have to draw the graph. Now I am going to draw the graph of secant x. See, I am taking domain x, x-axis, codomain axis, y-axis. Right? So I am taking where secant is not defined, at odd multiples. So directly I am taking 90. Interval 90 interval. So it is pi by 2 plus pi by 2. 180, pi plus pi by 2, I am adding pi by 2 equally to get equal values. Pi by 2, next I am adding pi by 2 plus pi by 2, pi plus pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 plus pi by 2, 2 pi, 2 pi plus pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, plus pi by 2, 3 pi, like this. Left hand side also I am taking minus 3 pi by 2, minus 2 pi, minus 5 pi by 2, minus 3 pi. Okay, right? Now I am taking 0. So at odd multiples of pi by 2, secant is not defined. So that's why I am taking the vertical lines at pi by 2, at 3 pi by 2, at 5 pi by 2. Okay, here also left hand side, at minus pi by 2, at minus 3 pi by 2, at minus 5 pi by 2. I am taking the vertical lines. Why? Because at odd multiples of pi by 2, secant is not defined. Suppose I am taking in between these two vertical lines, how the curve will be lies in between these two vertical lines, secant. For that I am taking 0. Secant 0 is what? 1/cos 0, cos 0 value 1. So if I take this as 1, this is the output. Okay, suppose I am taking known value in between 45. This is 0, 90, 45. Secant 45, 1/cos 45. Cos 45, 1/√2. So this is root 2. Cos 45, root 2, root 2, 1 point something. Here approximately I am taking 1 point something here. Suppose this is 2. Okay. I am taking unknown known value cos 60. Cos 60 1/2, secant 60 2. So it will be here. If you take pi by 2, then secant pi by 2 infinite. Why? Because cos 0 1/0 infinite. So it will go like this. It will not touch the vertical line. Okay, next left hand side. Suppose I am taking secant minus 45. Secant minus 45 again. Plus secant 45, 1 point something again. I am taking minus 60, secant minus 60 again plus secant 60, it will be 2. Again it will go on like this. But it will not touch the vertical line, okay? It will not touch the vertical line. So it will be extended like this. Okay, right. Now I am taking how the curve will be lies in between these two vertical lines. Now I am taking pi, secant pi. What is secant pi? secant pi is 1 by cos pi. Cos pi value minus 1. Cos pi value 180, 90 plus 90. Second quadrant, sin 91 minus 1. So if pi secant value, cos value minus 1, minus 1 by 1, minus 1. If it is minus 1, then here we will have the point. Okay, here we will have the point. If you take pi by 2, more than pi by 2, here more than pi by 2, no? Pi by 2 something, 180, this is 90, no? In between 180 and 90, you can take 150, suppose I am taking 150. This is 90 and this is 180, in between I am taking one value, 150. Secant 150 is what? 1 by cos 150. 1 by cos 150, you can write it cos 90 plus 60. 90 plus 60 will be minus sin 60. Minus sin 60. Root 3 by 2. So it is minus 2 by root 3. Minus 2 by root 3, minus 1 point something. Minus 1 point something means somewhere here. Okay, this is 180 and this is 270. From 180 to 270, you can take any known angle. 180 to 270, I am taking 180 plus 30. Suppose I am taking 180 plus 30, 210. 210. Secant 210, somewhere here. 210. 210 value 1 by cos 180 plus 30. 180 plus 30, which quadrant? Second quadrant, third quadrant, so minus cos 30. Minus cos 30, minus root 3 by 2, so it is also minus 1 point something, somewhere here. So it will be like this, downwards. And it will not touch the pi by 2 vertical line, and here also it will not touch the vertical line. So it will be like this. Similarly, if you find from 2 pi, at 2 pi, what is cos 2 pi value? Cos 2 pi, secant 2 pi. Secant 2 pi, 1 by cos 2 pi. Cos 2 pi, how we can write? 360. Cos 360. 1. Cos any even pi, even multiples of pi is 1. 1 by 1 is 1. So 2 pi is 1. So you can take here. So like this, you will get curve lies between these two vertical lines. So in the similar way, if you are getting here, again you will get second vertical line here. Cos minus pi, again cos pi minus 1. So here again in vertical lines like this. And see here, cos range is plus 1 to minus 1. But secant curves, this is range of cos, minus 1 to plus 1. But secant curves lies above the plus 1 and minus 1. So what is the range? And it includes 1 also. It includes minus 1 also. Except this part. In this area, we don't have any curve of the secant. Now, by drawing this graph, we can conclude that, after the graph, we can conclude that, therefore, domain of secant x r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2, n belongs to 0. This is domain. And range is all real numbers except this, in the values lies between minus 1 to plus 1, open interval. I am subtracting that values which are lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So you will get range all real numbers including minus 1 plus 1. But in between minus 1 plus 1, we are not getting by observing the graph. So this is the range and this is the domain of secant x. Right? Now let us draw the graph of cosecant x. Graph of cosecant x. And we know that cosecant x is equal to 1 by sin x. If sine function value 0, then cosecant is not defined. Sine, when it will be 0? When it is any multiples of pi, n multiples of pi, where n is integer. If you take 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, everywhere, sine will be 0. Sine pi, 0. Sine 2 pi, 0. 1 by 0, not defined. So cosecant is not defined. So at multiples of y. So domain will be domain of cosecant x. How we can write? Is all real numbers you can take, but except this n multiples of pi, n belongs to 0. Why? Because at multiples of pi, cosecant is not defined. Now, to know the range of the cosecant x, again we have to draw the graph. Again, I am taking few values: 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 5 pi by 2, 3 pi, minus 5 by 2, minus pi, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 2 pi, minus 5 pi by 2, minus 3 pi. Where it cosecant will not define, at sin 0 it is not defined. Sin 0. Cosecant 0, no? Cosecant 0 means 1 by sin 0. Sin 0, 0. So 1 by 0 not defined. So at 0 also it is not defined. At pi also it is not defined. This is also you can consider as vertical line. At 2 pi also it is not defined. Cosecant line. So take the vertical line. At 3 pi also not defined. Take the vertical line. Here also draw one vertical line. Vertical dotted line. At 2 pi it is not defined. Vertical dotted line. Right, this is also one vertical line. Here also it is not defined. Now I am taking these two vertical lines. I will check how the curve will be. Right, how the curve lies here. Suppose I am taking pi by 2, 90, cosecant 90, 1 by sin 90. 1 by sin 90 value, sin 90 value 1, 1 by 1, 1. So if it is 1, then here you will have the point, right? This is the image, right? Suppose I am taking any value, known value in between 0 to pi, this is pi by 2, I will take 30 here. Cosecant 30, 1 by sin 30. Sin 30, 1 by 2, reciprocal of 1 by 2, 2. So here, suppose this is 2, then here you will get, right? This is 90, 90 plus 30. 120. Suppose I am taking cosecant 120 here. This is 180, this is 90, no? I am taking another known quantity. Cosecant 120. Cosecant 120. Cosecant 120 you can write as cosecant of 90 plus 30. Cosecant of 90 plus 30, secant 30. Which quadrant? Second quadrant. Second quadrant, sine and cosecant are positive. So you will get secant 30. Secant 30, 1 by cos 30, 2 by root 3. Right, cos 30 root 3 by 2, so 2 by root 3, so 1 point something, 120 here. See, by observing this, you will get like this, again, graph. At 2, it's at 2, 30, but at 0 it is not defined. So it will goes on like this. Okay, now I am checking the graph in between these two vertical lines. At pi, it is not defined, okay. At pi, it is not defined. Just nearly pi plus 180 plus 30. 180 plus 30, this is 270 and this is 180. 180 plus 30, 210. I am taking 210, known angle 210. Cosecant 210. Cosecant 210. Cosecant 210, how we can write? Cosecant of 180 plus 30. 180 plus 30, which quadrant? Third quadrant. Third quadrant, cosecant minus cosecant 30. Cosecant 30, 2, so minus 2, that means we are getting negative value. This is minus 1, this is minus 2. For 210, I am getting point here. Okay, right, negative value. Now, I am checking at 3 pi by 2. Cosecant 3 pi by 2? Cosecant 270, that is 3 pi by 2 is nothing but 270. 270, how we can write? 180 plus 90. 180 plus 90, third quadrant, minus cosecant 90. Cosecant 90, 1 by sin 90 minus 1. So here it will be. Now similarly, you will get this type of curve by taking the known values in between and you can check the images, you will get like this curve. So by observing this, see in this vertical lines you are getting from images from 1 to more than 1. And in this vertical lines from minus 1 to more than minus 1. Right? Below the curve, below curve. Again in this domain, if you take 5, 5 by 2, then you will get 1 here. Again you will get like this U-shape which is open upward. In this you will get like this U-shape which is open downward. By taking in this two vertical lines, see here, cosecant, suppose cosecant minus 5 by 2, cosecant minus 5 by 2, cosecant theta minus cosecant theta, cosecant minus theta minus cosecant theta, minus 5 by 2 minus 1, so automatically here also you will get the shape like this, U shape, which is open downward. Again here if you take minus 3 pi by 2, you will get plus 1, you will get plus 1 and curve will be like this. Here minus 1 and like this. Now this is the graph of cosecant x. And sine range is what? Sine range. Sine range is plus 1 to minus 1. Sine range is plus 1 to minus 1. See here, in between plus 1 to minus 1, we don't have any curve. So range of cosecant always 1 or more than 1. Minus 1 or less than minus 1. Understood? But not the range, range not lies between minus 1 to plus 1. It is above, from 1 to above 1, minus 1 to below minus 1. So we can conclude that the range of cosecant will be, by the graph we can observe that, by the graph we can observe that, we can observe that domain is domain of cosecant x is r minus n pi, where n belongs to z. Range, range is all real numbers except minus 1 to plus 1. This is the range of cosecant x. Okay. Now cortex graph. Graph of cortex. Graph of cortex. We know that cortex is cortex is sine x cos x by sine x. We know the ratio of cortex, cos x by sine x. If sine is 0, cot is not 0. That means at x equal to n pi, at x equal to n pi, n belongs to z, cot x is not defined. At x equal to n pi, cot x is not defined. Why? Because sine will be 0. So domain will be, domain is, what is the domain? R minus n pi, n plus 2. This is the domain of cortex, right? Now to know the range, I will draw the graph of cortex. So I will take known values 0, pi by 2, same values. Here, pi plus pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 5 pi by 2, 3 pi. Left hand side also, minus pi by 2, minus 3 pi by 2, minus pi, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 2 pi, minus 5 pi by 2, minus 3 pi. Where cosecant is not defined? At multiples of pi, at 0 also. Why? Because sine 0, 0, this is on vertical line, where curve is not available, where image is not available. So I am drawing the vertical lines where the chord is not defined, at 2 pi, at 3 pi, not defined. At minus pi also not defined. At minus 2 of pi also it is not defined. Now I am taking these two vertical lines to check the graph of the chord. At 0 not defined, okay. At 30 degrees, chord 30. Chord 30, tan 30. Tan, opposite of tan 30. Tan 30 1 by root 3, chord 30 root 3. Root 3 value 1 point something, so positive value. So if it is 1, here I am taking for 30, okay, for 60, cot 60, tan 60 approach it, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 0 point something, 1 by root 3, 0 point something. So for 60, you will get here somewhere. At pi by 2, cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 by sin pi by 2, cos pi by 2 0. So image 0 at pi by 2, at pi by 2 it is 0. This is 90, no? More than 90, I will take 120, cot 120. Cot 120, how we can write? Cot 90 plus 30. 90 plus 30, which quadrant? Second quadrant, so minus cot. In place of cot, you will get tan 30. Tan 30, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, minus 0.5. Minus 0 point something. Suppose this is minus 1, here I will get. At pi, similarly, if you take 60, 90 plus 60, how much? 150. If you take 150 here, this will be 60. You will get tan 60 minus 1 point something. So you will get here like this. At pi, cot pi, cos pi by sin pi, sin pi 0, cos pi minus minus 1, minus 1 by 0, minus infinity. So it will be goes like this. The curve will be goes like this. At pi by 2, it will be 0. Like this, but it will not touch the vertical edge. It will not touch the vertical edge, right? Similarly, here also, in the similar way, here also you will get like this. This is the graph of cortex. Here also you will get like this. If you take the known values, you will get like this. It goes on like this, and downwards you will get the negative values. Here also. Right here also, it will have zero value at pi by 2. Add multiples of pi by 2, cos will be 0. So numerator 0, automatically 0. So here also, if you take article length, you will get like this. Now this is the graph of cortex. Now by observing the cortex, the graph lies everywhere. So everywhere is the image. So what is the image of what is the range of cortex by observing the graph? Real numbers. All real numbers is the range of the cortex. Now write down, by observing the graph, by observing the graph, cortex domain is R minus N pi, where n belongs to z, and range is all real numbers. Okay, right. Now these are the graphs of sine, cos, tan, cot. Okay, sine x, cos x, tan x, cosecant x, secant x, cot x. This is domain, this is range. Let us recall again, what is domain? Very important, you should remember the domain and range of trigonometric functions. What is the domain of sine x? Sine x is defined everywhere, all real numbers. Cos x also all real numbers. But tan, for tan, not all real numbers. Why? Because cos, if cos is 0, tan will not be defined. So we should subtract 2n plus 1. Odd multiple of pi by 2, it is not defined. N belongs to that. This is the domain. For cosecant x, 1 by sin. So when sin is 0, cosecant is not defined. Where sin will be 0? At any pi value, sin will be 0. So this is the domain. Secant x is not defined when cos is 0. So where cos will be 0? At odd multiples of pi by 2 is cos is 0. So pi by 2, n belongs to z. This is the domain. Cot not defined when sine is 0. So sine, where sine will be 0 at multiples of pi, n belongs to z. Now these are the domains of sine, cos, tan, cosine. If sine 0, then range close interval minus 1 to plus 1. We know the curve like this wave, right? It will be as a seems to be a wave which lies between minus 1 to plus 1. Cos x also same minus 1 to plus 1. Tan x we will get like this. So everywhere we will have the image. So all the are numbered. Cosecant x. What is the cosecant x? Cosecant x, you will have all real numbers except this part, minus 1 to plus 1. In between minus 1 to plus 1, we don't have the curve, right? Secant x also same, minus 1 to plus 1. Cot x, again all real numbers. So you should remember this range and domain of the trigonometric functions. Okay. Now, let me explain some domains, how to solve the, how to get the domains of the given function. For example, he will give only definition of the function, we have to find the domain of the function, right? Suppose, find the domain of f of x is 1 by x. I am going to find the domain of the function f of x equal to 1 by x, right? See, given function, solution, given function, I am taking only elementary functions, given function f of x equal to 1 by x. What is domain actually? Actually, x axis is the domain. You can take any real number on x axis. If you take any real numbers, if you get the image, then that will be, function will be same. We can say the function is defined. When you are taking some value on the domain, in the domain, if function is not defined, that means if you are not getting the image, that time this function is not set, we cannot say as a function. So function means in every element of domain, it will have the image, right? Suppose I am taking 0 in place of x, from the domain I am taking 0. 0 is there, no, in real numbers. If you substitute 0, 1 by 0 not defined. So function is not defined at 0. So what is the problem for this function? You should not take x as 0. You can take any real number. So the domain of the function. So f of x is not defined at only x equal to 0. So therefore domain of f of x is equal to 1 by x is all real numbers you can take except 0. Why? Because I'm getting the problem with 0 only in place of x. If you don't have 0 in the domain, so no problem. So I'm restricted the domain. Actually, domain is real number. I restricted the domain. Why? Because those values are not possible to giving the image, that values I am removing from the real number. So r minus 0 is the domain of this function. Understood? Suppose I am taking another elementary function f of x equal to root x. Now I am going to find the domain of this function. Suppose I am taking root x equal to in place of x 0, root 0 0. Suppose I am taking 2 value 1 point something. Suppose I am taking 4, 2. Suppose I am taking minus 1, minus 2. You can take any real number, no? Minus 1, minus 2. When under root, if you have minus symbol, they are not real numbers. So we should not take under root values, negative values. Any negative value, any real number, you should not take. Only positive values, you can take 0 also. So where this function is defined? F of x equal to root x. We know that f of x equal to root x is defined for only x greater than or equal 0. Only x values which are greater than or equal 0. Greater than or equal 0 means what is the domain? Now clearly domain is from 0 to infinity. Close interval 0, not open, 0 to infinity. Understood? Close interval 0 to infinity, right? This is the domain of the function root x. Suppose another function. As another example, I am taking 1 by root x. We know root x defined for only positive numbers. Only for these values it is defined. You can take 0 also. But here now root x in denominator. If you take 0, root x is defined. But 1 by root x is not defined. Understand? Now, to get the domain of this function, again I will restrict the domain. Right? F of x is defined. Is defined only for x greater than 0, only positive values. If you take negative, root is not defined. If root is not defined, function is automatically not defined. Root x is defined at 0, but if you substitute 0, this function is not defined. Why? Because here root x is in denominator. So for this values only f of x is defined. So what is the domain? Clearly, domain of f of x is open interval 0 to infinity. Open interval, I am not including 0 to infinity. Okay. For example, I am taking another example. Domain of f of x is equal to root of x minus 2. How to find the domain of this function? We know that root x is defined for only x greater than or equal to 0. Only root x function is defined for, that means under root function, whatever it may be, under root, if you have under root any function, that function is greater than or equal to 0. That is, root, suppose this is assume as f of x, is defined for f of x greater than or equal to 0. If any function under root, if you have any function, you can take this condition. So this function is defined. Therefore, clearly, f of x equal to root x minus 2 is defined for x minus 2 greater than or equal to 0. From this, you will get x greater than or equal to 2. So 2 or more than 2 values only you can take and you can substitute, and then you can get the domain. Images. So only those values which are equal to 2 or greater than 2, that values only will satisfy the function, will give the image of the function. So therefore, domain is closer interval 2 to infinity. Okay. Suppose it is in denominator. Suppose I am taking another function f of x equal to 1 by root of x minus 3. X minus 3 root, under root function, when it is defined, under root function, if it is greater than or equal to 0, you can take 0 also. If you take this value 0, this one is not defined. So this is defined only, if x minus 3 greater than 0, only for positive values. In place of this, if you take positive value, then only this function is defined. So x is greater than 3. That is, from this condition you will get x greater than 3. So what is the domain now? Domain is open interval 3 to infinity, the domain of the function, right? Suppose I am taking f of x equal to mod x, another example, find domain. Find domain, right? For what values of x you can substitute and can we get images? Yes, for every real number you will get some image. For negative also positive, for zero also positive. So what is the domain? Clearly, domain of x, I'm not asking range, we are discussing about domain only. Domain of f of x is all real numbers. You can take any real numbers, nothing will happen. It will define. Okay, suppose same example I am taking as find domain of f of x is equal to 1 by mod x. This is in fraction form, denominator should not be 0. When it will be 0? If x equals 0. So domain of f of x equal to 1 by mod x is all real numbers except 0. You should not take 0. If you take 0, this will be 0. Not defined. Right? Same example. Suppose I am taking like this. Another example. F of x equal to 1 by root mod x. Find domain. Find domain. Now check. What is the domain of this function? For what values? For under root value. Under root function is greater than 0. Why? Because we should not take 0. If you take 0 here, 1 by 0 not defined. Right? So above function is defined. Above function is defined. Function is defined. Defined for mod x greater than 0. When mod x will be greater than 0? For every negative number. If you take negative number, no problem, it will be greater than 0. Except 0, you can take any real number. So what is the domain now? Domain of real numbers. Domain is r minus 0. You can take negative or positive, always greater than 0. This is the domain. Okay. Today these problems are enough. Tomorrow again we will discuss domain and range of the some example functions. Thank you.